Hi, everyone. My name is Melina. I'm part of the developer success team. I've been part of Turing for more than a year now, and I really love this community. So today I will be walking you through the main steps that you have to go through as you apply to Turing and giving you some tips to do that successfully. So let me share my screen. So you guys can see what you'll see first, because once you join Turing for the first time, then the second time you'll see it a bit differently. So the first thing you'll see will be a piece of code that you'll have to complete that will allow you to, as you complete it, log in the website. So the very first thing that you'll see as you sign in will be an invite to upload your resume, which will allow you to start shaping up your Turing profile. Then you'll have to provide us the very minimum details to basically help us learn where you're at, to get in touch with you, and your availability. So this is just a sneak peek of what most of you might have seen, but let me actually show you the main areas of our website. So this is our landing website. As you log in, you'll start in the home. You'll get to see the main steps that you have to go through, which are basically completing your profile, taking tests, passing a live coding challenge, and then shaping up your resume a little bit. After that, our team will take over and help you. So some other things that you can find here: the perks of joining Turing. It's a Silicon Valley company. You'll get to earn a better salary in most countries. You'll work with amazing people and you'll be paid on time. You can also check other developers' experiences. We have some amazing testimonials from our team, and you can learn a bit more about the company. But let's get into it. Let me show you my profile. By the way, I'm not a developer, so this is something quite random, but we will invite you here to add a small summary of yourselves as professionals, which is one of the very first things that customers will see, your future clients will see as they check your profile. So your Turing profile will mainly focus on the technical side. Right here, we strongly recommend you to add as many skills as possible. You'll get to see how many jobs we have for each of them. So feel free not just to put your main tech stacks here. We strongly recommend you to also add some other tech stacks or frameworks you have used at some point. You can put here the years of experience, the seniority you feel you have for each of those tech stacks. And with all of that, our team will be working to match you. Once you finish the profile, you'll get to put your education level. This is something which we are very flexible. You can put any kind of title here, and then we'll invite you to the Turing tests. So I know that there's a lot of questions around all of this. So the main tests that you'll have to take here are a seniority assessment and a couple of technical tests. With the seniority assessment, we will be checking your level of experience to match you accordingly. And with the other tests, we will verify the skills that you actually have. The seniority assessment is quite short. It's a multiple choice. And the same thing goes for the other tests. My advice here is to study before you take these tests, browse the technology that you want to apply for, since you'll have to wait for 3 months to reapply in case you fail for that particular test. But if you fail one test, that will not affect the other tests that you passed. That's something important to know. And you will be able to continue with the process and reapply later on for that particular tech stack. Although we ask you for just a couple tests here, my advice here again is to take as many as you can to stand out. Remember, we will not be able to consider you for example, some job that requires 4 or 5 main tech stacks if most of them are not there, even though you may know them. So then we have a decoding challenge. It's composed of mainly two questions. It takes 30 minutes. You'll be able to switch with between questions. You can start with whichever of them you find easier. Remember, it cannot be paused. So that's why we have created a practice test for you to see how it looks, what you'll have to do. Let me show you how it looks. So over here, you'll be able to choose whichever language you are most comfortable with, the one you want to use. Over here, you'll be able to switch the questions and start with the question you prefer. And then once you actually take the main test, remember this will be recorded. It's important to do that with your own code, and please make sure to test it before you submit it. After you do so, our team will be checking your code and you'll be able to go to the final section. Over here, you'll be able to add a few more details about yourself, your work history. Now, this is a very important part of your application. The profile you'll be building here will allow you to skip some other interviews in other business models you may have to end up in a technical interview. Just by completing this once, you'll be able to have access to multiple applications with companies. This goes for the entire process. You can see this resume, your profile, kind of as a written interview. So the things you want to showcase here are the main companies you work for. If you have a long work experience, focus on the main projects you worked at. You can showcase the main features you build, some achievements, for example, if you have any metrics. You can focus on the technical side, but also remember to focus on the user side, on the impact that what you built had. So I put something random here. Over here, you'll be able to add more projects and more experiences. Those are two different things. Inside one company, you may have had many projects, sometimes even at the same time. Of course, we will not ask you to focus on every single one of them. Just showcase the ones that are aligned to the skills that you are applying for. And finally, once you finish this part, down here, you'll be able to submit it and you'll go to the final step. So right here is when our team will come in, your profile will be ready, and us in the backend will be working actively to match you. We also have kind of like a marketplace for customers to see your profiles, to browse them, but our team will be mainly working actively to match you. So that is why you have over here a jobs website, but you don't really need to apply to jobs by yourselves. Our team will be working on that. If you don't hear about us within 4 weeks or so, feel free to reach out to us and our team will be assessing you. Down here, you'll see the program. You can invite friends that may not know Turing yet. And up here, by the end, you'll be able to update your availability. So remember, your availability is something that will matter once you finish the process. Once you finish the process and you pass the tests, the coding challenge, and wrap up your resume, only then you'll be actively matched to shops on the backend. So please remember to keep this up to date. And if you have that flexibility, try to provide an availability as soon as possible. So basically, that's a little bit about the website. Great. Do you have any questions? Hi, Uma.
Hey, thank you so much, Meli. That was super helpful. Thank you. You can stay here. Let's also invite Melissa now. Melissa is our longtime software developer that was hired through the same vetting process that Meli just walked us through. And Melissa actually has been participating a lot in our developer town halls and community events. And recently, he's actually moved into a full-time community manager position at Turing. So Melissa, do you want to share your experience of how your journey has been and what advice, tips, like how to prepare for tests? I think that is something you could maybe guide the attendees with.
Yeah, thank you very much, Uma. I'm very happy to be here. So my name is Malisa. I've been working at Turing for like just over 2 years now. Yeah, so before I joined Turing, I used to work as, an engineer for so many years. I think for over 15 years, developing systems here in Africa. And currently I'm in Kenya, and I have worked in many different countries around Africa, developing systems and doing certain community activities. So I'm very, very interested in community activities as well because of that. I worked at Microsoft. I've done projects in Kenya, Uganda, Zimbabwe, and have also done many community activities, including in West Africa. So when I joined Turing, I was looking for a remote work. So the way it happened is that I saw an advert on Facebook, and then I just decided to try it out, and it kind of just so worked. I did the tests. I know the initial thought that most developers would have is to fear the test and say, you know what, will I actually manage to do it? I had that very same feeling as well, but it was not as challenging as, you know, as if I had not prepared. So the basic thing to do is to basically prepare yourself, go to HackerRank, LeetCode. There's a lot of content right now on YouTube on algorithms and data structures. Just ramp up your skills when it comes to the particular tech stack that you use. And then once you're ready, it's always a better thing. Yeah. So when I did the test, I was called in for an interview, which went well. And then I was told that I've been accepted. So during my time at Turing, I've worked with a couple of clients, and I've had a chance to work with some of the most brilliant minds around the world. So it's a very nice environment for you to also learn, like you actually grow your career from there. So I've had lots of opportunity to learn very different things. I've had to learn using some programming languages that I was not very conversant with. So it has been a great experience. So what I encourage you to do is just prepare yourself for the test, and also just study a little bit of data structures and algorithms and your tech stack. That would be my first advice to you, and don't fear the test.
Thank you so much, Melissa. Maybe we can take a few questions. So one of the questions I see from Chris is remote time zones. How does one work when you are 8 to 12 hours ahead? So basically, developers are doing a minimum of like around 4 hours in the time zone that our client is in. And the other 4 hours are flexible. Usually the client is flexible with the other 4 hours. So that's typically how our developers are doing right now. When we work with you and the client, that is something mutually decided between you and the client as well. So there is an opportunity to be a little bit more flexible, but typically we have seen that our developers do 4 hours in the client's time zone and 4 hours in a flexible. Melissa, Millie, any thoughts?
That's basically it. Okay. It's just a 4 hours overlap. There is some companies that don't really mind so much, but that is what is recommended.
Yeah, by the way, if you are in a closer time zone, for example, in the Americas, feel free to put more hours once you meet with the team. That's also an option.
There is another question here. Can I get paid directly in dollars or the employer's currency?
So we use a platform that will allow you to choose whichever currency that you want to withdraw, and that will enable you to send your salary to a local bank account in a foreign country or via fintechs, like Payoneer, PayPal.
Do you consider teams or only individual developers? So there are clients that have hired several developers through Turing. We have several of our clients that have hired many developers. Is there anything else you want to add?
I think I should say that those teams are built by our own internal team. If the question is related to applying to the process as a team, I don't know if that's supported right now.
Okay. Yep, that makes sense. The application process is an individual basis. Cool. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining. We hope you found this session helpful. And we hope to see you going through the process and making your profile up to date and taking all the tests. If you need any help, please email support@turing.com and we'll be happy to assist. Thank you so much. Have a great day. And thank you, Melissa and Millie.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Uma.
Thank you.
Thank you, Millie.